Good afternoon, YouTube. So this is the inside of the gas furnace in my house. So this is the combined gas valve. So you've got your knob here off, there's the pilot setting and then on, and then here's the control module on top there. And so you've got the two TH terminals here, and then there's two TR terminals. And I'll cut in a picture showing how this valve was hooked up before. Before, it had one thermostat wire on this side, like this one, and then the other thermostat wire was hooked up to the other side. This red wire that comes off of the transformer was just floating right here. It wasn't hooked to anything. And likewise, the other black wire here was just hanging off to the side as well. It wasn't hooked to anything. And the black wire comes from the high limit switch. It's a two-conductor wire. This wire is hooked to the 24-volt transformer, and then it goes up over here to the high limit, and then the other wire comes down from the high limit. And like I said, this wire was just hanging, and this red wire was hanging, and then the thermostat was hooked up across the terminals on the gas valve. So I found a little diagram online that shows how it should be hooked up. So over on the right side there is your 24-volt transformer, and then one leg of the transformer should hook to the TR right down here, and then the other side of the thermostat should hook to the TH, and then the thermostat should hook here to the high limit. And then my gas valve doesn't have this connection. It doesn't have a TH-TR connection point there. So I put in a Lego lever nut here to connect those. But so yeah, the way this was hooked up, this wire here was just hanging. It wasn't connected to anything. So let me show you how I've changed that around here. So yeah, I left this thermostat wire hooked in here. This is in one of the TH terminals. And then I have the red wire, which comes off of the transformer, plugged into the TR terminal. And then right here, I added a Wago lever nut connecting the high limit wire over here to the thermostat wire. So basically you have 24 volts coming in from the transformer, goes through the high limit, comes back here, goes through the thermostat, and then into the gas valve, and then back to the transformer. And now the furnace works. So like I said, I don't use this furnace. This is the first time it's been turned on since 2011. And the reason I was turning it on is because I signed up for one of those utility energy audit programs. They're coming out next week to check the furnace, make sure it works. And I guess they want to fire it up and then check the carbon monoxide values and make sure all that's good. Like I said, this hasn't been turned on since the last time they were out. The last time I opened this up was when we opened it up in 2011 to light the pilot light down below there and run it through all its paces. So somehow these wires got all chewed up. One of the thermostat wires was broken, and then this wire and the red wire were just hanging out in space. They weren't hooked up to anything. The utility guys came out today and they couldn't get the furnace lit. So they're going to come back, send in their expert crew next week. But I figured I would take a shot at it. So I finally found my lighter that can reach back. You need a really long lighter to get back to the pilot light on this thing. But anyway, yeah, got her all running. The thermostat in the house works. At least when they show up next week, they can fire it up and test it out. I don't have the heart to tell them I don't use this furnace, but they need to check it off their checklist that they checked it. I guess that way they get paid for showing up and checking everything out. They checked my tankless water heater and said that passes, so they had no problem with the tankless water heater gas setup there. And so they're just going to check the furnace and make sure it's still working right, and then I will turn it off, and it'll probably be off for another 10 years. But man, I don't know what happened to these wires. I have never been in here since the last time I lit the pilot light. Let me show you the details on the furnace here. This is a pretty old furnace. So there's the nameplate. It's way oversized. This thing is 100,000 BTU per hour. And the house is about 1,200 square feet. And it should probably have something like a 35 or 40,000 BTU furnace. And then there's the lighting instructions. It's a real pain to light this thing too. Two guys from the utility, they gave up after about 15 minutes. And then it took me about an hour to get it lit once I fixed all the wiring. So it's a real pain. So hopefully it'll pass the test and we'll shut it off and button it up for another 9 years. You've got the four burners, the pilot's way on the end there. And you have to get way in there to get in like that far to get the pilot light lit. It's way on the back side. And then the furnace itself is really hard to get to because it was installed in a closet here. And it was probably too wide to put this way in the closet. You can only get into right where my hand is because there's a sliding door. So you've only got this much room to get in to work on the furnace. And then of course the pilot light is way as far in the backside as you can get. But this was probably installed sometime in the mid 70s, I'm guessing. Here's the thermostat. This is a really old ITT thermostat. That's your temperature setting. There it's on, there it's off. And then you've got your little bimetal coil. There's your thermometer, room thermometer, and then that's the bimetal coil for the thermostat. Yeah, so that's the old furnace of Fraser Johnston, 100,000 BTU per hour. Just a massive big unit. So that's the one that the air return comes in from the attic. And then I have my combined air return plus the whole house fan is sitting up on top of there. And then I've got a louver up there that I can either block the furnace off, or right now I have it turned open so it's pulling return air up there, over there, and then it comes down here. And then the furnace exhausts out the bottom. All the vent pipes go out the bottom of the furnace and then under the floor to the various registers. There's just the 24 volt transformer up there and then the integrated gas valve and the thermostat on the wall, and that's it. Pretty simple system, and I really don't want to spend any money fixing it. I'll put a link to the webpage where I got that little wiring diagram at, because I could not find a wiring diagram inside here. It's not on any of the panels. So I was kind of at a loss initially because I couldn't figure out what these wires were. But yeah, it's pretty easy to figure out. You've got the thermostat, two wires. You've got the high limit with two wires. And you've got the transformer with two wires. And then you've got the gas valve that has two terminals. So you just hook everything in series, basically. Pretty simple system, just two switches in series and a transformer and a valve. So yeah, if you have any questions about that, post up in the comment section below. And as always, thanks for watching.